Early instruments for borehole logging were invented as early as the 1920s and have been expanded and innovated upon ever since. Through much of that history, the advanced equipment used for this process was mostly restricted to the oil and gas industry due to its high cost and limited availability. As the knowledge and practice of wireline logging became more widespread, the water well industry found many applications for identifying the in-depth characteristics of the geological formations many rely on for usable water. In this first video, we will briefly discuss common wire logging techniques and how they function to identify formation characteristics.
Natural gamma ray instruments consist of a Geiger-Müller counter or sodium iodide scintillation crystals used to measure the radiation emitted from the decay of uranium, thorium, and potassium-40 within the formation. Natural gamma ray logs can be used to identify porosity and lithology, as well as estimating shale content of the surrounding formation.
A spontaneous potential sensor consists of a single electrode connected to a grounding point via a galvanometer. This measures the voltages at the contact points between sand aquifers and shale or clay beds. SP logs can be used to identify the shale and clay content, permeability, bed thickness, and salinity of the formation's water if certain conditions are met. For this method to be effective in freshwater wells, the difference in salinity between the drilling fluid and the formation fluid must be considered. Also, it can only be used in an uncased hole filled with conducting fluid.
Density logs, or gamma-gamma logs, use emission of gamma rays, typically from the isotope cesium-137, into the formation and detect gamma rays that are scattered back. These instruments measure average electron density, which strongly correlates with bulk density. Typically, a predefined matrix is used, such as sandstone, limestone, or dolomite, but readings can be adjusted after collection. Readings come from the invaded zone and do not penetrate too far into the formation, so the investigation area is limited. For optimum results, an uncased well is required, and these instruments are used to identify bulk density, porosity, moisture content, and lithology.
A neutron porosity logging tool emits high-energy neutrons in the formation and measures the time it takes for them to slow down into an energy state more consistent with the formation. These methods are most reactive with the high concentrations of hydrogen atoms found in water and hydrocarbons within the formation. Therefore, it is best used to measure characteristics such as saturated porosity and moisture content, which can also help identify lithology. Like density logs, a matrix of either sandstone, limestone, or dolomite must be defined within the instrument before measuring or compensated for afterwards.
Sonic velocity, also known as acoustic velocity logs, use a transducer that produces a pulse of sound that travels through fluid and rock to a probe. These probes use piezoelectric transducers to detect electrical energy and convert it into acoustic energy. For accurate readings, the borehole must be 3 to 16 inches in diameter. Similarly to density and neutron porosity logs, identification of a matrix is required, but may be adjusted afterwards. These instruments are used to identify intergranular porosity, lithology, fluid properties, permeability, and more.
Resistivity logging instruments generally use probes to generate an electric current between the borehole and the surface. The instrument then measures the electrical resistivity, or the ability of the formation to withstand the flow of electricity between two points. Similar tools induce a current within the formation to measure conductivity, which is the inverse of resistance. Different methods can identify lithology, fluid saturation, permeability, porosity, changes in dissolved solid concentrations, salinity, and certain contaminant plumes. Most methods require conductive drilling fluid in an uncased hole, but electrical induction methods can be applied to boreholes with plastic casing.
Borehole image logs can be broken down into two main types of instruments that have essentially replaced dip meters. The first is acoustic scanners, or borehole televiewers. For accurate measurements, a fluid-filled borehole is required. Acoustic scanners transmit acoustic energy from a rotating transducer, and that energy is reflected back by the surrounding material and detected by the transducer. These instruments are often used alongside electrical resistivity instruments for a more comprehensive image, with acoustic scanners responding to rock properties and electrical responding to fluid properties. These scanners are used to identify characteristics of both fractures and solution openings, as well as the strike and dip of geologic units. Additionally, acoustic scanners can also be used for casing inspection. Optical imaging makes use of a ring light, high-resolution charged coupled device, or a CCD camera, and a mirror that produces a two-dimensional colored image of surrounding formations. These instruments require a transparent fluid to produce quality images and are often used alongside acoustic scanners. They provide important information used for interpreting both hydraulic and water quality data.
Nuclear magnetic resonance technology has been made small and accessible enough in recent years to be operated in small diameter boreholes typical of the water well industry. This instrument uses a magnetic field to align the hydrogen atoms in the formation, followed by a pulse that then knocks them out of alignment. The tool then measures the magnetization strength and time it takes for the hydrogen protons to return to their original alignment. These readings provide in situ measurements for the derivation of porosity, permeability, pore size distribution, and water content in distribution. This instrument can be more useful for gathering temporal data to monitor changes in characteristics like hydraulic conductivity, porosity, and contaminant transformation. Due to the magnet, it cannot be operated in steel casing.
Calipers are tools with multiple arms used to map borehole size and shape along the depth of the hole. Large deviations in hole diameter can limit measurement accuracy. These instruments are used to make corrections on hole diameter for other logs, which can affect results of other logging techniques. Caliper logs are also used to identify characteristics of lithology, fractures in formations, and borehole volumes.
Often wireline rigs come equipped with auxiliary instruments that can be used to identify general details about the formation fluid characteristics and the well components. For established wells, this will include a casing collar locator, which locates the joints connecting each section of casing by detecting where the casing walls become thicker from overlap. It is a primary tool run on most modern cased hole operations, and it is used in combination with gamma ray logs for depth correlation of the cased hole and surrounding open holes. Lines may also include a fluid column temperature sensor, which detects the temperature of the fluid in the borehole, a fluid column conductivity sensor for measuring resistivity directly, and a sensor for measuring the net flow of the borehole.
The instruments listed all take key measurements that, when used in combination, are useful in identifying major formation properties in both oil and water wells. In addition, skilled geophysicists paired with advanced computer modeling can infer numerous additional properties through a deeper understanding of how their mathematical relationships pair together and of a significant amount of background data. Many properties, such as permeability, are never directly measured. We will briefly go over the basic properties each method identifies. Natural gamma ray and spontaneous potential sensors are mainly designed to characterize lithology. Resistivity and sonic logs can aid in differentiating between lithological and fluid-based responses. Borehole imaging and caliper tools are best used for borehole mapping and sensing formation features like fractures, voids, and stratigraphic orientation. NMR is an advanced technique that is initially used to identify porosity and pore size distribution. Similarly to most of the measurements from wireline logging instruments, the data can be used, especially in combination, to make inferences about many other characteristics. In our next video, we will discuss interpretation and application of these techniques. Thanks for watching. Leave us a comment with any topics or videos that you would like to see next, and make sure to rock that subscribe button.